recording.
Don't make me. I'm trying to find out everything we need to know.
Yeah, it's recording.
Have been on the trend trail, and we have sent our video hero to discover who the most talked about celebrity of the week is. That all sounds banging, but there's one thing I've been absolutely loving this month, and that's the fashion weeks all around the world that's happening this September. I'm talking London, Milan, Paris, and New York. And you know what? One of my favorite things that I love about Fashion Week is the Get Ready With Me videos. I'm talking transitions, fashion hauls, whatever it is. I love it. It's literally iconic. So, instead of heading to the red carpet, I've enlisted the help of a friend to give me that fashion knowledge and, fingers crossed, hopefully go viral. Let's see how we got on.
Hi, Shireen. How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Good, yeah. Welcome to my favourite charity shop on the planet. I'm so excited to show you some things.
Well, I'm actually a bit nervous, right? Because I've had some fashion disasters over the years.
Oh, haven't we all? Honestly, your fashion sense is amazing. Don't even.
But I'm hoping you've got 3.5 million followers, and I think you're more than certified for this job. Can we create something?
Of course we can.
Yes, let's get started. Finding your style.
My style is like masculine and feminine, and
I love
mixing it up.
Now, you have to be so comfortable in what you're wearing, of course, because that's how you feel confident, and that's how the clothes will resonate with everyone else that's looking at them.
Confidence
is key. And honestly, if you do find yourself, you know, not actually resonating with a lot of things in your wardrobe already, there's always some things that you can pair with something new, so you don't necessarily have to throw it away straight away. And if you do find that you don't really work with it, then you obviously you can give it to a charity shop later on.
So old is a new.
Yes, of course.
Okay, perfect, because I've got tons of old stuff.
Yeah.
And Hannah's got me creating my own look.
All right, I'm coming out.
Okay.
Big reveal.
Oh, amazing.
So here I am in my brother's shirt and my old jeans.
Yeah.
I do like it. I just think it's a little bit boxy.
I think that we can do some revamping with that.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Check out that instant restyle. All right, Hannah, I'm ready for step three.
You look amazing.
Thank you.
I think this is something that you go for every day.
Exactly. Something I go to the shops and go get a pint of milk.
Yep.
Very cash.
So I think we're going to switch up a little bit.
Okay.
Step three, think outside the box. So I think we're going to play a little bit of a game. You up for it?
Okay, I'm scared. But yes, definitely
up for it. Okay, so it's this really, really viral trend that's going around at the moment. Don't know whether you know it.
Yeah, I think I know
what So we're going to close our eyes, we're going to walk along,
I don't know where this is going.
And we're going to pick something up,
and
we're going to try whatever it is on.
I'm going to go fast.
Go fast, super fast.
Interesting.
Stop.
Oh no, I don't like the feeling of it.
Stop.
I'm done. Stop. You picked the cutest thing there. Stop.
Hang on. Let's go.
Three, two, one. From a fashion fail to a fashion all hail.
Don't tell me we're not ready for step four.
So, you should be able to create any look now.
So easy peasy. It
doesn't have to be too fancy, it could literally be anything.
And express myself.
Yes.
Okay,
you ready?
Yeah.
So, give me birthday party chic.
Girl,
oh!
This jacket is stunning.
Double denim, we're rocking it. I want dinner with the grandparents.
What do you think?
Perfect. Granddad will love it. Give me school prom.
Give us a twirl.
I nearly fell. But listen, we've absolutely smashed it. I'm very proud of us.
I've had so much fun. Same.
But what's step five?
Probably one of the hardest of them all. Everything that we've learned, we're going to put it into 15 seconds to show your friends and family.
Got the phone?
Okay.
Step five, let's put it all together.
So, guys, be honest. Tell me, what did you think? Sweet. Well, do you know what? That was a lot of fun. But if I'm honest, full-time job. And I've already got a full-time job right here, finding out what we need to know and love every single week. And next on my list is finding out who the most talked about celebrity of the week is. Luckily, I've got our video hero to reveal all.
Hey Shireen, I'm going to tell you all about which celeb everybody's talking about right now. But first, you need to know a little bit more about me. I'm Aurora, I'm 10 and I'm from London. And here's my love, love, love grid. Okay, so this first picture was a time when I made my birthday cake and I worked really hard on it. But then, like, when we got down to eat it, my sister ate all the icing and ate most of the cake. Okay, and then this other picture was when me and my mum and my little sister doing like makeovers. My sister should definitely be a makeup artist. The next picture is when I went to Devon and we went surfing for the first time, and me and my sister were really good at it. And now here's a little clue of who I'm gonna be.
Is it Joel Corey, David Guetta, and Ella Henderson? Maybe all three at once? Nah, there's no chance. That would be way too easy. So I'm thinking it must be someone that's friends with this top class group of mates. I'm going to have to go to the group chat and get a little help on this. Guys, what celebrity is friends with this lot? I'm hoping they can help me out, but there's something that tells me Max and Harvey are a little bit tied up, because they promised me that they're going to queue up the hottest playlist with the one and only astronaut, Tim Peake.
Tim Peake, astronaut and CBBC fan, and now an author. Welcome to the show. Thank you so much for being here.
Hi, Max. Hi, Harvey. Thanks for having me on the show.
Now, Tim, we all know you as the man who spent 6 months in the International Space Station. Could you even listen to any music up there?
It's really important up in space because it helps us to relax. It reminds us of planet Earth.
Tim, is the Earth round or flat?
Categorically, guarantee that the Earth is very round. I went round it 3,000 times, and every time I went round it, it was round.
Yeah. 3,000! Do you have a song for us that you sort of listened to while you were up there?
One of my favourite songs was A Sky Full of Stars by Coldplay.
Of course it was!
Add it to Q. We also know that you're a wonderful author as well as an astronaut. We want to know everything about your new book.
My new book is Swarm Enemy, and this is the second in a series. It's a fun kind of adventure story, really, but it's all about aliens.
We want to know what song you think would be the best anthem to defend Earth from an alien invasion.
You're probably going to be in space defending Earth, so why not Sam Ryder's Spaceman?
I see where you're going with this, Tim. Nice.
Heard that you got to choose three tracks to listen to just before you were being launched into space.
Yes, so to help you relax, our instructors play some music in the capsule.
Of your launch songs, which one would you choose to add to our queue?
My launch song is going to be U2, Beautiful Day.
So, Tim actually listened to this while waiting to take off. How cool.
Add it to queue. Songs into your queue, and so we want you to guess as many songs as you possibly can in 30 seconds just from hearing the intros of the songs.
I might just set an all-time low here.
But are you ready for the challenge?
Oh, go on then. Okay.
Go on, Tim.
Is this Ed Sheeran?
No, it's Cold Heart, Elton John.
Next song, next song, next song.
Pass it. This is that one's Coldplay, My Universe.
Yeah. When you made the joke earlier about doing the worst, you did get one. But you know what? That is still absolutely amazing effort. We appreciate you talking to us. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Max. Thanks, Art. It's been great fun.
Tim Peake's actual playlist in my phone. If an astronaut tells you to do something, you do it right away. I mean, this is so cool. I can't wait to tell my mum. Oh, Donnell has just texted me. He's got a theory about who the mystery celebrity is that our video leader's teasing us with.
Shireen, I think this person's already collabed with all of his people, you know? But then again, they all collabed with, like, everyone, so...
A collaboration? I think you might be onto something, Danelle. But celebrities aren't the only thing that's trending this week. There are tons and tons of other things. Luckily, I have got you covered. This is this week's biggest hashtags.
Hashtag London Marathon.
So if you can't work out who I am, just remember I've made a lot of chart history. Keep guessing. I wish you well.
You wish me well? I actually can't tell if you're winding me up or if this is a genuine clue. Right, while I figure this out, Max and Harvey are going to bring me what they think is the biggest trend this week. Let's see.
Trend team, what's happening?
It's corn. Corn is happening.
You know what, for once you're actually not wrong, because this week's biggest trend is all about corn. Shireen, luckily enough, introduced us all to Tariq, aka the Corn Kid. Have a look.
I love corn. Corn. Have a bite.
It's corn.
Because corn is awesome.
Of course, everyone's favourite corn fan Tariq has gone viral after his declaration of love to corn.
And since, this song has gone massive and it's all about corn.
I literally have it in my own playlist.
And honestly, it's gone so viral that the song has so many trends attached to it. You could lip sync.
For me, I really like corn.
What do you like about corn?
It's corn! A big little bit more intensity.
Or make up a dance to it.
It's corn!
You could dress up like corn, or you could just eat sweet corn to it.
What do you like about corn?
It's corn! A big little bit more intensity.
I mean, I am not surprised everyone has jumped on the sweet corn bandwagon. It literally is the king of the vegetables.
And it's the perfect time of year because it's bang on UK harvest time.
Wait.
Literally awesome. How did it feel?
Well, it felt really good. I loved dancing. It was a really fun time. I also loved bossing Max and Harvey around, and I just really enjoyed it.
Listen, I was literally blown away. Thank you so much for bringing us Becky Hill. We'll see you soon.
Bye, Shireen.
Bye. Yes, we are so on trend. We know how to make the best fashion content. I'm literally in space with Tim Peake's top class playlist. We've got the biggest hashtags this week, and to be honest, I'm going to spend the rest of my week practicing Max and Harvey's favourite trend. Plus, they had our very own Becky Hill. What a show! But I wonder if next week we can top it. Remember, don't just like it, love, love, love it.
Hey there, everyone! You can enjoy the next step at any time.
Yeah, you can watch any episode on iPlayer.
Just like when we won regionals.
Ooh, yeah. Yeah. Like the time that Lily You can't get to Rochelle's feet.
Okay.
Or when B troop stepped up to go to nationals instead of A troop.
No.
Maybe not.
That one.
Well, you can watch your favorite moments if you take the next step into iPlayer.
All aboard for Mallory Towers the Game. As the newest pupil, explore the grounds to your heart's content. Follow your new friend, Daryl Rivers, as she shows you the ropes. Attend classes, make friends, and fill your friendship meter to be awarded Head of Form. Or if pranks are more your thing, I've heard the matron's scared of spiders. Or create smelly stink bombs. Pee you.
That's too funny.
Play the Mallory Tap.
Our playlist, head to the music tab on the BBC Sounds and press play on Charged Up. Right, let's rock on with our mini mashup. Andy James in the soundtrack. Hit it.